Welcome to CADMED. This is our third class in which we will be discussing some more sketches, tools, the sketcher workbench. So now some of the other sketching tools in the sketcher workbench will be seen here in today's class. First of all, part mechanical design, part design, then okay. So now here select a plane, enter sketch. Now we are in the sketcher workbench. Then switch on or off the grid here. So now we are going to see in the profile toolbar, we will see the ellipse tool. So select this one, same as previous tools here, just click on wherever you want and drag the mouse, and then the an important thing here, sketcher toolbar, where is it? It is the sketch tools toolbar. So here you can see the variations here. First of all, we will be giving the major axis. You can enter the value here directly. Give like 100, you can give. Next one, give minor axis is 50. Then give angle as 0 degrees. You can see here we got the required thing. I have given the major dia as major radius as 100, so the total dia becomes 200. The same way, minor dia as 50, so we got it 100 mm. The angle is 0 degrees. Then instead of giving these values, you can directly go for ellipse. Just draw the cut somewhere and drag it, and however you want, and which way you want, you can do it. You can do like this, and okay. And now the you can drag like this, and okay. We got this. So you'll be wrong by this. Just need to give the major and minor axis. And HV value, nothing but the positioning with respect to the absolute axis, H and V. Suppose we are given the positioning as 100. And sorry, here H value is 100, 100, and the major axis has major radius is 200 and the minor radius as 30. So here we have this one. The center of the ellipse is at a distance of 100 from V and 100 from H. The center. Whereas the major axis, major radius is 200, so it got total 200 plus 200, it became 400. Whereas here 30 plus 30 60 is a minor radius, minor dia. Now this 100 by 100 is a position with respect to the absolute axis, both x and y. This is how it is. And coming to the next one. The next thing you are going to see here is the drawing lines. We'll be seeing the drawing lines here next. Prior to that, one point, please note down one point regarding the ellipse. The Cartier V5, especially, the first axis of an ellipse is termed as the major axis, even if its length is less than the minor axis. So the first axis of an ellipse is termed as the major axis, even if its length is less than the minor axis. Please note down, this is the note in case of ellipse. So coming to the splines, here the spline. Select this one spline. You can draw number of points you want. So the spline was. So splines, they are the curves whose behavior is defined by piecewise function of polynomial equations. So the next thing we'll be seeing in this tool is nothing but in the spline drop down. This is connect. So you can, in the spline, you can give the multiple points and you can draw multiple lines using your different orientations and different angles. But it's not a straight line. It won't be a straight line. Whereas in the spline, the control point on the spline are the construction elements, while the curve is a standard element. So here, the number of points you can see, these are the points, these are all the construction elements which are used to construct the spline. You can move the points to change the spline, whereas you can't change the shape by just changing, selecting the line, because it is just a standard element. Whereas this points you are using, these are the construction elements which are plays a main role in spline. You can just drag the points to change the shape of the spline. Whereas if you want to select the line, you want to change the line by selecting the line, it won't be changing, it's just moving. It is not constrained. So here the points are the construction elements, while the curve is the standard element. So coming to the next thing, but connecting two elements by a spline or an arc. I will be connecting by use the connect option, which is shown in the spline drop down. Say this as a, what do you mean by drop down is, you can see the arrow, black arrow here, that shows, that indicates that there are some other options included in that. So when you click on this, because we'll get a new toolbar, it's nothing but drop down of a main toolbar. So in that we'll be having circles, so you can delete it, close it, and you can find it in the drop downs. If you want it separately, you can just drag it and you can keep as a separate toolbar, but the main toolbar or a parent toolbar is are shown with the arrow mark, indicating that they are children of a parent, something like that. So in this line drop down, we discussed about spline. Now we will be seeing the connect tool. Select this connect, and if you see here, there are different operations that can be done by using this connect. What are the different possibilities, the different ways that you will be using this spline connect tool? In this, you can see this, see them in the sketch tools toolbar. There are different types: connect with an arc, connect with a spline, continuity in point. And the next one, continuity in tangency, continuity in curvature. So you'll be seeing the each one now. First one is a continuity with an arc. So first of all, we'll be drawing the spline here to this here somewhere line. So here you can see these are the two splines here, different splines. So if you want to connect to them, spline connect, and select this, connect with an arc, and select this. You can see this, it is connected with an arc. You can just move it. This is how we'll be connecting with an arc. So we'll try the next one. This is how they connected with an arc, and then go for the next one. Connect with spline. Suppose select this point, this one, and this one. See, they are connected with the spline. Suppose we'll, instead of selecting the point, we'll see what will happen if we select this to the nearest point, two points were got connected. If we use this connect with this line option, so coming to the next one, we'll see continuity in point. select this one, select this point, and select this point. This group points are connected with the straight line. Suppose if you select, see what will happen. Select this point, select this point. These two points are connected with the line. This is nothing but join the two points, continuity in point. Whereas this continuity is tangency. Select this one, select this point, select this point. You consider these two are of those two points are of different two different splines. Just consider like that, and you see this continuity with the tangency. We call it tangency here. The tangency here means this line is tangent to this point, whereas here this is tangent to this point. So that is continuity with the tangency. That's how it is. And the next one, continuity in curvature. Select this one, select the two points. We got the continuity with the curvature. So this is how this continuity option works for joining the two different splines in different ways. So coming to, we'll see the next one. Drawing elongated holes. Here, if you see, coming to the circle, here it's not there. Here, it's a rectangle, you see the elongated hole. So, select this one, and you can give a radius, and first center. You can give the radius as 20. Click on tab. Now the first center is like 500 horizontally and 500 vertically. And the length should be 100. Angle should be 45 degrees. Yeah, you got it. Yeah, with respect to the origin in H and V, it's 500 position at the first point, and with respect to the first point, the second point is at the length of. Let's at the length of 100 from the first point, 100 mm from the first point, whereas the orientation is 40. The angle which is given is 45 degrees with respect to h axis, but horizontal axis is shown like 135. Here it is 45. So that's how it is. Or else you can directly draw without giving the values here. Later we'll give it later, like the way you want, you can give it and you can give it. And now here you can, by using the constraints option, you can give the values of the lengths and widths and radius as per your requirement. You can give directly in sketch tools, or else you can simply draw it and you can modify the dimensions, give the dimensions using the constraints tool. So that's what this drawing elongated hole. Okay, coming to the next one, it's cylindrical elongated hole. And select this one, it's similar to this elongated hole, but only changes the cylindrical shape. See, select this one, select this one, and drag the mouse. Press this. That's how it works. Can even can give the values you want from here, radius and circle center. This is the circle center point. Can give the values for position with respect to H and V and the radius. The radius which you have mentioned here is the center radius. Now this cylindrical along with the pole, this is the center axis. The center axis radius will be given here, and the small this radius is nothing but this radius of the semicircle radius, small radius. There's the angle, and what are these two are the angles. With respect to the H for the first one and for the second point. Suppose I give the radius as 100 and the position as minus 500. 5 plus 500 and the small radius as 20. The first angle is 45 and the second angle is 120. Now let's see. Let's do it again. I think something got wrong. The first radius is given as 100 in the radius, and next position is minus 500 and V plus 500 and R. Small r given 30. Can give it like 5 here. And angle, first angle is 45. And the second angle is 135 given. And let's see if we got something here. Yeah, obviously you got it, but you're unable to. I can see you got it, but maybe something is wrong. What happened? Maybe anyway, it doesn't matter. You can just draw it like this directly. Maybe like radius 500 and horizontal minus 1000, vertical 1000, and radius 30. Right, 20 and 160. Or something here. Let's find what is what. think problem is that here there should not be 30, there should be 500 even. So what else I need to change? Something I think this radius should be small. This radius should be 50. Let's say this radius keep 20, and this one keep 1500, and this one keep 2000, and this one keep 500. This one is 40 degrees, and 180 degrees. Now we got it. There's some mistake in the radius. This is the major radius and this small radius here. Small radius. The major radius. Yes. So this radius is a mistake. So that's how you're getting this cylindrical elongated hole. So now we're going to draw in keyhole profiles. Coming to the next one, this is a keyhole profile. Select this one, select this one, and draw a line here. This is a keyhole profile. You can adjust and can change the dimensions by using constraint toolbar. Double click on it. So in this color, it indicates that it is over constrained. So let's remove this one. And you can drag it. And you can change the radius. And this is the value for it. Can change what are the values you want as per your requirement. You can change the values, you can get the profile as per your dimensions, or else you can give the values here directly, horizontal positioning, its horizontal and vertical positioning, and the length, and the other one is the angle. This center to center is the length. Can give the value here, and there is the, here is the angle with respect to the horizontal and vertical axis. So that is about this keyhole. The next one is hexagon. Select this one, give the center here, and you can just drag it and give the position HV and the dimension. The dimension and the angle. The dimension is nothing but the length from the center, the radius. So you got, you can even give the dimension values. You can try it by giving the values here. Give the center value and give the dimension as 100 and the angle as 90 degrees. That 90 degrees is with respect to the horizontal axis, and this is the thing we got in the hexagon. Value given 100 is shown here 100, the total from one end to other end is 100 and then there's the angle and sides will be coming as it is hexagon. So that's all I said about the hexagon. Coming to the next thing, it is center rectangle. Select this one and select any point and you'll get the rectangle with respect to the center and get the length, height, width and HV values, or else you can just like draw it with a horizontal and vertical. The center rectangle. And the next one is centered parallelogram. The same as it's just the changes and give the center here. Sorry. Centered parallel, select this. It's not getting. So, for example, select this center parallelogram, select this one, and in the hexagon, you will select these two lines, and you can see this centered parallelogram. This you can find, I will show you. So observe clearly, centered parallelogram means so this line is parallel to this one and this line is parallel to this line. So this, the two lines are parallel, the parallelogram is formed, the centered parallelogram is formed parallel to the selected two lines, and that position centered, position is centered. So this is how the centered parallelogram works. Nothing but the opposite sides of a parallelogram will be opposite sides of a parallelogram will be parallel to these two lines, this one and this one. The opposite sides are parallel to these two lines. This is nothing but centered parallelogram. Now we'll be discussing the conics drawing, different types of conics like hyperbola, bifocals, parabola. So these different conics are there. Be discussing them now. Let's see here. You can find in ellipse, parabola, bifocals. Select this one. Or suppose select the first point. What I observed here is, well, in this parabola by focus, to use this option is first select the focus point, select the point here, any point, and you can, what do you call that as a peak, like a peak of the mountain is there. It looks like a peak of the mountain. Now we already fixed the apex point. Sorry, that is the focus point which we have fixed it at first. Then the apex point need to be fixed. This is the apex point. We have fixed the apex point. Next, select a point somewhere here. This is the first point, and second point. So this is the parabola by focus. Parabola by focus. In this, first we will be creating the focus point, then the apex, then go for first end and the second endpoints, start and endpoints. So I will draw it again for you. Select a point somewhere here, and the point which we have selected is the focus point, and you need to fix the apex point at some distance. Whatever the distance you require, you can keep that there and select. Okay, then you need to create a start point somewhere, and then create the end point somewhere here, anywhere you want. Then this is how the focus parabola by focus. And coming to the next one, this is hyperbola by focus. See, let's see how the hyperbola by focus works here. Select the hyperbola by focus. Then see here how the hyperbola by focus works. Select here. So after selecting the focus, then select the apex point somewhere here. Select the apex point. Select it. And then there's the start point and the end point. This is how the parabola. This is parabola. Sorry, it's a hyperbola. Hyperbola by focus. Again, I will draw the hyperbola by focus. Select this one and just create a focus point. Then create a point somewhere on the top. You see this hidden line and dotted lines. Hyperbola will be like it will be tangential. See, I'll creating a point above, and then it's asked for apex point. You can select the apex point, the start point, then the end point. Parabola created. So if you still have doubt regarding this parabola and hyperbola, you can just search in the web what is parabola and what is hyperbola. You can get a clear information in it. You can browse in the website and come into the conic. Select this line, select the point. So let's see about the conic here. Select the conic option, draw two lines, like the construction lines here. The conic formed the point and the line, tangent to the line, and the point of contact here, point. So suppose you select this again. Create one line and do another. So if you see here now, conic is formed tangential to these two lines at the end points of these two lines and tangential to it. The conic is formed. So suppose from right here, at this point, and this point, you see the conic is formed here. And suppose if again select the option, this point and select this point, and you see the conic is formed here. So this is the conic. This is how the conic works. That's it about the drawing conics. Now I'll be telling you this editing and modifying sketches using some modifying options and editing options. Now we'll be seeing them. You can see them here in the operation toolbar here. Yeah, this is the operation toolbar. Click it here. And just bring it back. Yeah, so this is the operation toolbar. There are some editing operations can be performed in this. The first thing in this you will be seeing is streaming options. First of all, I will just clear this, all this stuff here. Deleted it. Well, you see how this works. Streaming options. Yeah, first one. First of all, I create two lines here, multiple lines here. The line of line tool here, create multiple lines. Then coming to this trim option, select this trim, and there is a sketch tool for sketch tools. Which one is sketch tools? And in this, if you see the trim all elements, and the second one, trim first element. So select this one. This one, good. Suppose this one and this one. Did you get it? Can use this for extend also, both. This two lines are selected, these two are joined. Like this line is extended to this line, and this line also extended to this line. So these two lines get joined. So suppose again I will show you here. Selected this line, selected this line. These two are joined, extending up to this point, to this point of contact. They are extended. The trim can be used as in both ways. Both for extending and both for trimming. So suppose I'll try here again the line. So you can see here the trimming option, trim all elements option selected. Selected this line and this line. The selected lines remains up to this intersection point, and the remaining will be trimmed. Suppose I can see, I will select this line and this line, and the remaining after the intersection point has been trimmed off. And suppose get back again. Coming to this in the trim option, you go to this trim first element, select this one, and select the first element, and select the second one. Only the first one has been trimmed, and not the second one. Still remains like this. And again, if you select, suppose this is the first one selected, trim first element it is. So trim first element is selected, and the second one is selected. And what are the first one got trimmed off? So whereas here trim in trim all elements, but if you select this trim all elements, first one, select the first line and select the second line. So see what's the difference here, you can find it. So that's about the trim option. Coming to this break, first select this one and select this line, select this line. So what happened here? I will do it again. I will select this line and select this line. Broken here. The reason it may be. Suppose create a line here, and if you use this break option, select this line and select this line, second line. You can see the first line is broken at this intersection of the second line. So if you see this, these are the two different lines, whereas the second line remains a single one, whereas the first line is divided into two different lines as it is broken into two pieces by the second line. This is how the break option works. It's just this break. And whereas this quick trim is commonly or mostly used instead of using trims of different kinds of trims, the quick trim is like mostly used. Like you can give the trim option wherever you want, just delete whatever you want in the quick trim option. There is no issue of the first line or second line, just trim using this easy way. So I prefer quick trim in order to avoid this confusions of first trimming or second trim or trim, like using instead of using this. Where is this sketch tool? Here is it. Instead of using trim all elements or trim the first element, instead of just to avoid those confusions, just go for the quick trim. You can trim whatever the line you want instead of the trim all elements or trim the first one. And the comment is close arc and complement. So the what about this close arc, you will see now. Select this close arc, and first of all you need to create the arc for it, I think. Where is the arc here? Suppose I've created arc here. We'll use this close arc option. Just close the incomplete arc into a complete circle. So use the close arc option. Coming to this complementary. I'll do first again create an arc here. Is created an arc here, and let's select this complement, then select this one, select this complement, and select this one. What you are getting is the other missing part will be displayed. This is this is semicircle, or this is just an arc. Instead of close arc, there is a complementary in the sense the missing circle will be displayed, highlighted, and this visible line will be switched off, will be hidden. Select this circle. The other piece has been came into light, that the selected piece is just vanished. So this is a complementary circle. So let's see about the fillet option. Delete them and to create the fillet, first of all let's draw a rectangle which is normal to the view. Okay, click on this. Okay, go to fillet option, the sketch tools. You can see the different types of fillets here. One is trim all elements, trim first element, no trim, standard lines trim, construction lines trim, construction lines no trim. Can give the radius value here, give like 3. Directly give it like this, and it is the first element. See, the first element has been trimmed. There is a second select element to remain as this. Let's come into this one, no trim. This one. The fillet has found, but no trim has been done. The lines remain active. Come into this fourth one, standard line trim. Select this one and this one. I think there is no much difference between this no trim and standard line trim. I'll show the difference here. I will tell the difference between these two later, and let's complete. I'll draw another. I'll tell you right now. Draw the another rectangle. And the rectangle has been drawn. And I will do one thing. I will just extend this line. That I need to extend this line. There is a trim option here. Yeah, it is. I'll extend this line up to here, and this line up to here. Then now, coming to the fillet. What is this standard line fillet? Select this one, and do the fillet. I've seen what happened. It's the same thing now again. With no trim option. Select this one and this one. Create a fillet and see the difference here. I found it. And see the construction lines here. The construction lines will be created. Can see these are the construction lines, and coming to this construction lines with no trim is same as that of no trim. The only difference is the lines will become like a construction line. That's it. That's all about it. Then now this is all about the fillet, and coming to the chamfer. Where is the sketch tools? Yeah. Coming to the chamfer, there is no difference between the fillet and chamfer. These are all the different types of operations. They remain same. The only change is instead of radius, should be a straight cut, straight corner cut. The chamfer. So you can try the chamfer. The same is almost same as the fillet. The only change is instead of radius, the chamfer will be straight. That's it. And coming to the next one, we'll see this mirror, symmetry, translate, rotate, scale, and offset. We'll see all these options now. Coming to the mirror option, we'll select this mirror option and select this edge play. I need to select this first. I'll select this one and select this line H. I see this is the mirror. The same object is mirrored here. And again, if you want, you can select this one. Select this one. You see it is mirrored here. So this is a mirror option I can use. And I will show what is the difference between the mirror and the symmetry. This is a symmetry. What the hell is not selecting? We'll see the symmetry option. Select this and select this. It's not selecting. What's the value of the reason? Selecting. Correct. We'll delete those things now. We'll see the symmetric option here. Select this one. And then symmetry. Select this one. Hold on 1 minute. Something is wrong here. Press Ctrl U. Wrong with it. And suppose take this one and select this one and select the symmetric option. The symmetry with respect to horizontal line. Even you can do that, you can give the symmetry and just you can create a line here, something with some angle, and you can just select this one and this is a symmetric option and select this line. It will be symmetrical to this. The difference between symmetric and mirror. In mirror you can see the both sides. There is no symmetry, only other portion, other side, the reflected portion will be shown. Suppose if you do the same for the same drawing, if you do the mirroring, select this one, mirror with respect to this one, and you can see the both the mirrored one and the original one. Whereas in the this symmetry, only the mirrored one will be shown, whereas the original object will not be shown. So that's the main difference between the mirror and the symmetry. So coming to this translate, so select this one, just want to translate something, select this translate option, select the object, do the number of instances, sorry, it's 5. Keep internal constraint or external constraints, and give the direction. What are the direction? Like for the distance and orientation, you can give the distance here, the value. It is how much distance it should be. Even you got the this absolute x or z, because we selected that also. So instead of that, just select only this one. Select this one. Do the translate and give the direction as you wish. Select this point. With respect to this point, then give the spacing and the orientation. This is how it works. Translate and coming to this under one rotation. Select this rotation. And first of all, select this file and select the rotate option. Instances is selected 5. And with respect to this, I selecting the center point. With respect to this center point, and you need to give the angle and give this one. So this is how it is coming. Suppose I will tell you again, selected this one and select rotate option and taking the center as I'm taking the center as the origin, absolute origin, and the angle with respect to vertical or horizontal axis I'm selecting with respect to horizontal, and with respect to horizontal the angle to be given I'm giving 360 by 5. How much it is? 72 degrees. So angle I'm giving 72 degrees. So this is how you got this. To prepare the sequel, each pattern is oriented at an angle of 72 degrees. So that's about this rotate option. And coming to the next one, scale option. I'll tell you now what is the scale. Select this object and select the scale option. I need to select a center point for it. So suppose I selected this one, you can see by now itself you can see the scale. The scale is more than 1. This size has increasing, whereas it's less than 1, the size has been decreasing. And you can see the duplicate mode has been on, so that you can see the both. Suppose you switch off this duplicate mode, we'll find only the final, won't be seeing the original one. So that's the scale option. If you switch on the duplicate mode, you can see the both. Suppose it's on, selected this one, selected the center as this one, so switch on the duplicate one, you can see the both. That's how it works. And coming to the next one and last one is called offset. Select this one. There are different types in it.
In sketch tools you can find out a different operation that can be performed by using this offset tool. What are the capabilities of this offset tool, and what are the different operations that can be performed by using, what are the different possibilities by using this offset tool, can be seen the sketch tools itself. See this no propagation type, tangent propagation, and this one point propagation, and both sides offset, as well as held in the first time no propagation, selected this one, and it can give the offset value. It's just parallel to it, can give the offset value. Give the offset value here, offset value, or else you can manually leave it somewhere. You can get the dimensions. The dimension is getting, you can see the dimension because of this dimensional constraint. If you switch off this and you do this again, you can see there is no dimensional constraint, only the geometrical constraint is present. Suppose if you do it again without this geometrical constraint, offset, there is nothing, no geometrical constraint, no dimensional constraint. So we'll switch on these two and we'll proceed with. And now that is about this no propagation. And coming to this tangent propagation, select this one and select this one. And you see here the offset has been made as this curve is tangential to this line. So the curve is also automatically selected when I selected this line. That is the tangent propagation. Whereas I do it again with this point propagation. Select this one. Okay. And I'll do it one thing. I'm just telling you one more example. A little more helpful, I think. Let Just take this as example and select this offset option and doing this tangent propagation. Select this line and you can see the tangent, both the tangent curve and the line has been selected. And whereas when I select in this point propagation, you can see both point corner and the tangent propagation both are selected, so the whole one is selected. And whereas when I go with this both sides offset, select this one and selecting this one, you can see this offset is done on both sides. This is how the both side offset works. So guys, this is about offset operations, and I think with this I will end up the today's session, and I will show you some tutorials, practice exercises that you can practice on your own. If there is any doubts, you can just comment on that. I will be helping you with that particular issue. So we'll go for this practice exercises. I will show you now. So these are some of the exercises we can practice. That's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed my section. Even if you don't enjoy, it's up to you. I tried my level best and keep on trying it to help you people to get a free knowledge. I want to share what I know with you all and get your thumbs up. Have a good day, guys. Bye-bye.